الله أكبر، الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته وسار على هديه إلى يوم الدين. عيد مبارك، كل عام وأنتم بخير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our deeds, accept our fasting, accept our qiyam, accept our ibadat, and make this blessed day, insha'Allah, a day of prize, a day of reward, and a day of ghufran. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. My dear respected brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with this season of Ramadan, a season of ta'at. Upon its completion, we come in droves in paying dues to our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which we will praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we will celebrate, and we will remind each other like our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminded us when he came upon Medina, and he saw that they were celebrating some old traditions in Jahiliyyah, and he told them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has substituted for you 2 days every year in which you celebrate your ibadat, the Eid al-Adha wa Eid al-Fitr. Each one of these ibadah comes at the tail end of a completion of one of the pillars of Islam. Our deen revolves around the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even our happiness, even our joy, even our joyous occasions are done so that we can glorify and celebrate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Falhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. My dear brothers and sisters, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes for us what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does for us in this wonderful day of Eid. And he describes, and when he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that إذا كان يوم الفطر وقفت الملائكة على أبواب الطرق ينادون أن اغدوا يا معشر المسلمين إلى رب كريم يمن بالخير ثم يثيب عليه الجزيل ويغفر الذنب العظيم لقد أمرتم بقيام الليل فقمتم وأمرتم بصيام النهار فصمتم أطعتم ربكم فاقبضوا جوائزكم حتى إذا صلى الناس نادى مناد ألا إن ربكم قد غفر لكم فارجعوا راشدين إلى رحالكم فهذا يوم الجائزة فهذا يوم الجائزة ويسمى في السماء يوم الجائزة. My dear brothers and sisters, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gives us the glad tiding. He says that when the day of Eid come upon you, and as you exit your homes and as you take onto the roads going to Salatul Eid, the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are greeting you at every corner of your salah as you are making your takbir and coming to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will call upon you and say, oh, the droves of Muslims, you are coming to a very generous Lord, a Lord who has asked you to pray and required you to pray, and you have done. And B, have the glad tidings of the great rewards that will come upon you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs the angels to say, you have been ordered to make qiyamul layl, and you have. You have been ordered to make siyam, and you have. You have been ordered to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you have. So you deserve your rewards. You shall be granted the great prize, the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم تسأل الملائكة في هذا اليوم ما جزاء الأجير إذا عمل عمله فيقولون إلهنا وسيدنا جزاؤه أن يوفى أجره فيقول سبحانه وتعالى أشهدكم أني قد جعلت ثوابهم لصيامهم وقيامهم رضائي ومغفرتي ثم يقول سبحان الله تعالى وقد نظر إلى جميع المسلمين نظرة رحمة وحنان سلوني يا عبادي فوعزتي لا تسألون اليوم شيئا في جمعكم هذا لآخرتكم لأعطينكم ولا لدنياكم إلا نظرت فيه فقد أرضيتموني فرضيت عنكم فانصرفوا بعد ذلك مغفورين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes upon us, and the angels are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Prophet, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, what is the reward of those who have fulfilled their promise? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, رضائي ومغفرتي. The pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His forgiveness. What a wonderful day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look upon all the believers and He says, by my glory, O my servants, there is not something you ask me today for the sake of your hereafter that I will not accept for you. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-jannah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala His forgiveness, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you that He will give it to you. And then if you do not ask me for anything for your dunya, illa that I will look into it and I will grant it to you inshallah. My dear brothers and sisters, indeed a great day. Indeed a day for us to be happy, to be glorious, to celebrate amongst ourselves these blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many people feel the weight and the heaviness of what has been happening to our community. But if there is a day that we must show our resolve and must show our tenacity to celebrate and to remain strong and to bring about courage, it is this day of Eid. We will raise our hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask for His forgiveness and ask for His support. All the meanwhile, we will dig deep within ourselves and look for the courage that exists within us and look for the faith, the bedrock of our strength, the bedrock of our resistance, the bedrock of our resilience and our ability to remain steadfast as a community. You see, this is not a somber day. This is not a day for us to reflect upon hardships, but rather it's a day to celebrate our faith. We withstood 30 days, alhamdulillah, of complete devotion. The venues, the avenues, the roads of America lit up from the sky with those who are coming in droves during the day and during the night when everybody is asleep, when everybody is away from the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We were there making qiyam, making prayers, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the reserve and the strength within us so that we can come to this day. وَلِتُكَمِّلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. My dear respected brothers and sisters, celebrate. Show your children that you are happy and you're proud and you're very much in utmost happiness because of the completion of this ibadah. It doesn't, however, takes us away from reflecting upon our state of community, reflecting upon challenges that face us, because once we are imbibed with faith and strength and the spirit of iman that Ramadan results in our lives and in our minds, we are able, inshallah, to challenge and change and bring forth the transformation necessary from within and from without so that we can transform the realities that surround us. My dear brothers and sisters, in our remarks on the state of the community, I want to reflect on two things that I want everybody to be aware of. Think about it. Look deep down and see what is it that you can do about it and change, because the challenge is real. And the difficulties that lie ahead are there. But as I said, we approach them not from fear and anxiety, but we approach them with confidence and courage that we will, inshallah, see one day when we have removed them from our path. But we have to make sure that we are dealing with them. There is no doubt about the fact that Islam and Muslims in America today face a very big challenge from the Islamophobes and from the hate that is prevalent. A hate, my dear brothers and sisters, that has become institutionalized. It's not just the bigots and the haters. Now it is institutions and government agencies that are trying to implement a policy whose sinister aim is to denaturalize Muslims and denationalize Muslims. And that is a very important thing for us to understand. You see, we live in a society where diversity is embraced and there is a constitution that protects minorities. Religious minorities. There is dictums of religious freedom that allows us the right to espouse and live by our faith and to bring forth that which defines us, which is the Islamic faith. But there are people out there who are trying to say that Islam is not a religion. Islam is a political ideology. Islam is a violent idea. Islam is seditious. Islam is subversive, and so on and so forth. We must resist that tendency. We must educate and enlighten other members in our society to understand the beauty of this deen, the greatness and the vastness of Islam, and the fact that it is a religion that is protected by the Constitution. And our customs and our practices are just to be respected as the customs and practices of everybody else. We see it manifested when the permits to build masajid is being denied by people who think that they are serving this country, where in fact they're violating the very foundations and principles of this nation. So we need to embrace the foundations that makes us the nation we are. We need to not be apologetic about being Muslim Americans. We need to embrace the core of our deen, define our lives through the lights and the prism of this deen. Yet all the while that we resolve these questions of identity, the questions of who we are and what we are about, we're proud Muslim Americans. We people who live by Islam, but we people who serve and identify as an American, who can understand the ills of his society and who can embrace the good of the society and who can transform and make difference in a society, not to live on the margin of society, not to live insular and unable to affect and bring about change. That dynamic has to change. If we are driven by faith, if we are inspired by La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, then this is the area of our mission. This is transforming our society, is the very definition of what La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah means in the outer context. So we renew and revive the spirit of Islam within us, but we bring about a renaissance in our community. We bring about an understanding of social responsibility, social justice, the meanings and the foundations of our deen, and we take on the helm of reform and change within our society, strengthened by our faith, inspired by our iman, but also understanding the dynamics and the challenges within us. And so we can tell those, president or otherwise, and those in the highest echelons of power, that Islam is a glorious religion, is a glorious deen that has much to contribute as it has in the past. We were the bedrock that brought about Western Renaissance and Western civilization. Islam brought about the Renaissance and the civilization of the world. And it's capable of bringing that again and again, because it's a divine guidance that is based on these universal principles from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we will not allow anybody to call Islam a violent political ideology. Islam is one of the greatest religions. Islam is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islam is the divine guidance that it's meant for all of mankind. Let us be the relevant, inshallah, models who are capable of bringing it about. The second challenge, my dear brothers and sisters, that we need to be aware of, and we need to groom ourselves and educate ourselves so that we can understand how to best deal with it. As a religious minority in a community that is larger, that contains very diverse and very wide spread differences in beliefs and in ideas, we are challenged to grow as a community. We are challenged to understand the dynamics of the society around us so that we can make sure we are living in harmony with its principles, yet we are able to bring about the change that matters. And so when we look at the divide between the religious and the secular, we need not live in this anxiety and differences. We are a minority that's growing. My brothers and sisters, never in the history of Muslim Americans in America have we become ready and able to transform and affect our society. When our forefathers came to America, from the inception of America, they came as navigators with Columbus on the ships that discovered this land that we call America today. And many of them were forced to come here in ships as slaves. But they were stripped of their human dignity. They were stripped of their ability to be somebody who can affect and change the society. So it took many years for Muslims to grow and become an influential member of society. Today we are that community, my dear brothers and sisters. Today our brothers and sisters, our daughters and sons are in the best schools in the country, are in the best institutions, are able to make a difference and make their voices heard. So it is very high time for us to understand the dynamics of our society and make sure that we're not conflicted with that divide. For religion in this country is allowed to be practiced to the fullest. But the secular nation of the separation of state and religion is needed to bring harmony amongst the different diverse groups so that everybody can bring their light to shine. What happens in the future, what people decide to do in the future, that is up to the human interactions that we can bring forth. So we need to understand that as a community, we can have internal fortification and strength in our masajid, but the real path of work, the real area of challenge is outside of the masjid. That the real field of our mission as Muslim Americans is outside in serving the community, in serving members of society, in transforming the ills that befalls our human condition. And so we need to be inspired to be servants, to be leaders in social justice, to be leaders of change within that society. Because only then will we bring the light of Islam to the rest of the society. And only then will we be able to transform, inshallah, from within. Let's take those messages from within, teach our children, inshallah. The same week we were mourning the passing of our daughter, Nabra Hassanain, is the same day when we were celebrating the achievements of a young lady in the elections, in the local elections here in Washington, in Fairfax County. We will continue our resistance and we will continue our strength to move forward to make sure that we are affecting our community and affecting our change. Let us celebrate our unity, our strength, and our compassion as we celebrate the season of Ramadan, so that inshallah every Ramadan will become a stop for us and a station for us of progress that will bring about the transformation of our society. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Eid Mubarak. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. Inshallah, we will take the tradition of one, inshallah, khutbah without a second one. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd, wa kullu amin wa antum bikhair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.